I'm Tradu, and this is the second video in my series of VOD reviews for my kills in Mythic Nerubar Palace as a Shadow Priest. We're going to be looking at the Bloodbound Horror, and just like in the other videos, I'll start out with talents, which are going to be the same as I played on Ul'Grax. So that's Archon, Void Eruption, Shadow Crash on the like DPS side of things, and I yet again made the mistake of playing Phantasm over something like Void Shield, but it is what it is. It doesn't really matter that much either way. Just like Ul'Grax, this fight is mostly single target, but it has add phases. The difference is that here the add phases are assigned to groups. Either you go in the first breath or the second breath, and depending on which one you're in, the timings are going to change. I was in the first group, which is probably the one that's most convenient for Shadow because it happens to line up with 2 minutes decently well. But it just depends what you get assigned. I don't think it's correct to hold cooldowns for those adds regardless. So it's just a happy accident if you end up in group one. You're going to once again be playing Spymaster's Web and some kind of passive trinket. Spymaster's Web on this fight is going to be on pull, and then with your last CDs at the very end, because it's like a 5-ish minute fight, I make a mistake here and I use it with my second PI of the fight at like 2 minutes, and then I don't use it at all at the end because I guess I just forgot or something. But in theory, you want to use it on pull with whatever stacks you have, and then at the end with roughly 40 or so stacks. And another thing, just like Ul'Grax, I have a plan. I don't follow it super strictly, especially the fades, because just like on Ul'Grax, there's something you can fade basically on cooldown. You could probably macro it and be fine. Just like as well as on Ul'Grax, your Desperate Prayer is going to be in the breath that you soak with your assigned group. This is for soak one assignment. For soak two, basically just imagine that the Desperate Prayers are with this one instead, so down here. That's basically the only change between the two. For cooldowns, you just press them on cooldown. It's going to line up okay with add spawns. Like you can see here, I'm in group one. My cooldown is still running, like easily, by the time the adds come. Same thing here, CD is still running, and here. And then the boss should be dead by the time you reach this. That shouldn't be happening. You'll see I have dispersion in here because this gore splatter does a lot of damage. However, there's no reason really to disperse it because as Shadow you can just outrange it. The reason to disperse would be I can't hit anyway, so I might as well sit in dispersion. But thanks to our extra range, we can actually just hit the boss while out for the gore splatter. I do end up pressing dispersion for some of them because I get separated from my group, so I'm on my own trying to live. But you don't really need to. You can technically dispersion and stay in the gore splatter, but why would you when you can just outrange it? You will live. It does like 20 million damage or something base. You reduce it by 75% with dispersion. You live with just like normal gear and like a powered shield maybe. So you should be fine, but why would you bother? So that's the preparation. Let's look at the actual boss fight. As mentioned, I'm in the group that goes in the first breath. That's groups 1 and 3 in our case. You can see our adds are spawning over here. This pattern of add spawns isn't great. You ideally want them all three stacked so you can just crash them. But two together and then one on its own is fine. Chances are you're not going to be assigned to the extra add that's over where the hunter is running right now, because your single target burst isn't anything impressive, so why would you be the one assigned? So you just crush the pile, continue your CDs on them, keep your dots on the boss, because you might as well, that's just extra damage. For these circles, you are going to probably be a bit of a nuisance, because you have a lot of things that root you to the ground with your Void Torrent and your Mind Flay and so on. Like you saw at the very beginning, I kind of pushed the people into each other with my VoidTorrent, and then just barely moved out. Here again, we're spreading out, trying to find room. We've kind of stacked up with the other group, so I need to quickly jump out to not get killed by the second breath. If you get the tentacles, you can kind of stack them a bit. You can wait for two to spawn, then move, two to spawn, then move. I don't really do that very well, but you can, and there's probably, I would imagine, going to be a weak aura that shows you the ticks of when they spawn, so you can more easily manage to drop two, then move, drop two, then move. Here, to outrun the beam, it's a bit annoying. You have to press some bad GCDs to do it, or just press nothing like I do half the time. And you're also often going to end up being near the beam by the end, because other people can move more easily than you. Another thing you'll notice here is that I've actually ended up with the other team instead of my own, because I got behind and separated by the laser beam. So I end up dispersing and waddling back to them just in time to get breathed on, so we can get into the ad phase again and kill them. And you'll see I'm setting up my CDs here, pressing all of them. And then as we get in, I crash here between these two, manually do the third one, and then go ham. You can't really participate in delaying the ads, the small ones, from hitting the boss. You also can't really participate in doing damage to them unless your second shadow crash comes up. And you press that, like here, I get some of them. But your main focus here is going to be killing the three big men and then getting out of the phase again, because other people are just better suited for dealing with the small ads, both CC wise and damage wise. You can see, as I mentioned previously, my web stacks are pretty low because I used them with my second PI, and I'm just never going to use them again on this fight because I forget. And once again, I'm almost in the breath for the other team, but get out just before it happens. And you'll also notice the tentacles only do like a third, half of your health or so. So it's not the end of the world if you get clipped by one. You will live. What you will not live, however, is the beam. That will just one-shot you. Even if you press dispersion, it ticks. I think it's every quarter seconds for 20 million damage or something absurd. So you might live the first tick, the second tick will kill you. So don't bother trying to do anything cute. Just run away from the beam. Ideally, try to be just behind the beam, because then you don't get pushed quite as quickly. Because if you're just running ahead of the beam, you need to keep moving constantly. Here again, Gore Splatter's going on. I disperse because I might as well. I need to get back to my team again because I've been separated. The ads are spawning, but we're not getting breathed in for another like 5 seconds. But I go set up my dots, slowly go into CDs as I'm spreading out for this. And once again, the ads are not grouped very nicely. It's just pure RNG where they spawn. But you just want to try to shadow crash two and then dot the third one manually. I end up missing both of them with my shadow crash, which is unfortunate, and I don't notice for a while because I'm blind. The boss is also dead though, so it doesn't really matter. So yeah, that's the Bloodbound Horror. A much shorter fight than the previous one. Although the last one we also did make a lot longer than it should have been. I will once again put both versions of the note in Pastebin and link them in the description. So that's both Soak 1 and Soak 2. And I'll put a link with a 30-day duration to join the Viserio group thing to be able to see the notes directly there and export them and see if I've maybe updated them as I've reached later bosses as well. If the link has expired, just DM me on Discord or something and I'll figure something out and send you a new link. So yeah, thank you for watching, and see you for the Rashanon video, which is probably going to be the next one, as I'm, I was benched for the Sikran kill just to spread out some vaults. So I'll get around to that one on a rekill probably next week, if I'm lucky, and otherwise just later whenever I get a kill of it. Yeah, see you next time.